So hello guys, today we will learn about the JSON web tokens, and I have already created a project and I will show you what I have did in this project, and next we will see how to implement the JSON web tokens in it. Okay, so let's start. Let me open my VCode here. So this is my Visual Studio code. I'm going to see everything from scratch. Okay, so here I have created an API, API named app. Like, you can create it by using Django Startup API. So this app will be created, and in this app, let's go to models.py first. So here I have created a model named student, in which I have specified some fields like ID, name, roll number, and city. And these will be shown in our database only when we register them in admin. So I have registered them in admin. So for registering in admin, you have to import the admin from django.contrib. After importing them, you can register them. So at the rate admin.register student means this will get registered at our admin panel. After registering your app, you need to create a serializer class. Serializer class is here, I have created already. So from REST framework, import serializers. I have imported the serializer class from the REST framework, and then you have to import the models from student. From dot models, you have to import student that we have created this model here. You have to import from here this class. So in the serializer, when we imported the student class from the models, you have to specify in the student serializer. And when you specify that, then this complete model will get serialized. Serialized in the sense, now we can convert the student model into the JSON data that can be transferable on our API. So when someone will make the request, then it will get that JSON data with the help of the serializer class. Okay, so now let me move ahead. Now since our model and serializer are ready, then we can go in ViewSet. So here in ViewSet, we have to create a ViewSet. So what the ViewSet is, it is actually the API view that the user will see when it will come to our API. For example, suppose an user make a request, then ViewSet will handle all those requests by creating a CRUD on it. So how it will create the CRUD, let's see. First of all, first of all you have to import the view set from the REST framework. So from REST framework, import view set. So after importing the view set, now let's import serializer class that we have created. So from dot serializers, import student serializer. So now our student serializer has been imported. Now import from dot models, import student. So we have also imported student class from our model. Now the next, we have to import permissions. Like when some user will make request, it should be authenticated. So for making the authentication system, we will import from the REST framework. Now we will import is authenticated from REST framework. So from REST framework dot authentications, import is authenticated. Okay, it didn't show me something. I think it's REST framework dot permissions. So from REST framework dot permissions, import is authenticated. Now after importing that, you need to install Django REST framework simple JWT. So this will install the Django REST framework simple JWT in your system. So after doing so, from REST framework simple JWT, import token, sorry, dot views, import token obtain peer view to obtain our token, and token refresh view to refresh our token when it get expired, and next the token verify view to verify our token that it is expired or not. So after creating these views, you have to import JWT authentication. So how will you import it? From REST framework sample JWT dot authentication import JWT authentication. Okay, so now our all required file are ready. Now you need to specify the view set. So how will you do this? Class student view set. So from view sets dot model view set, here we need to define some variables. The first variable is query set is equal student dot objects dot all. The next variable is permission class. So permission class is equal is authenticated. So this will check if the user is authenticated or not. And the next authentication classes, here it will we will specify JWT authentication. So this will handle all things. You need not to write any code. This will automatically handle the JWT authentication. Next, we need to specify our serializer class. So we will specify it. Serializer class is equal student serializer, as we have already imported it here. That's why we specified here. Okay, so this will handle all complete view set and we can able to do CRUD on it. After doing this, let's go to our urls.py. Our URL. Now let's remove the unnecessary things from here. Okay, so in here you need to import this from REST framework dot routers, import default router, and you need to import all those type of tokens here. So from REST framework dot views, import token obtain pair, token refresh view, and token verify view. Now we need to give them a path. So when someone go to this get token URL, this view will be shown. Okay, token obtain pair view, and this will give the get token. I mean, this will give the token to our users, and refresh token will refresh the token and will provide what has been refreshed. So and this verify token will check if our token is valid or not. Okay, so now I think all thing is ready. Let's check if our project is working correctly or not. So let's run our project. Python ns.py run server. So I think the error is here. I have spelled it wrong. Now the error has gone. Let's see if our API is working or not. Okay, so this is our API, and let's click on it if it will work. So it's saying authentication credential was not provided, that is you are not authenticated. So let's use the postman for making our request and see from postman that our API is working correctly or not. So let me open my postman from here, postman. Okay. So our postman is ready. Now let me make request on our API. So let's send again. So authentication credentials were not provided, it is saying. Okay, so when we are making request directly, then it is saying authentication credential not provided. So we have to provide the authentication credential. This username and password in the body tag, I am giving providing the username and password, the authentication detail. So let's see. So authentication credentials were not provided. It is still saying that because the JWT authentication wants that we have to give a token with our request. So let's first get the token. So get token, the URL which we had made. So post. Let's make the request now. Now see, it is providing us two tokens. One is the refresh token and another is SSH token. So let's copy this SSH token. Copy it and then go to the authentication and choose here the bearer token and provide their token here. Control V. Now let's make the get request to our API to fetch all the students that we have. and student API, and let's send the request. So I think I have did something wrong. Take the token again. So now we have our token. Let's copy it. And after taking the token, we have to provide it in the token section and then send the request. Okay, I am getting the token again instead of going to our API. So let's copy this again. Copy, make this student API, because we want all the student data that are available in the database. So let's make the get request again and send. So now you can see all the data that are available in our database can be seen here. So in this way, we can use the Django authentication using JWT. So you can also specify in the settings to PY that what is the time that the token should expire. So control, I will uncomment this, and you can see here that I have given 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, the token will get expired. And the rotate refresh token is what? So this is for if we will refresh our token. If our token will get expired, then we can refresh this token by using the refresh token, so that we can use that again. Oh, thank you. This is all about Django JWT.